Marshall R. Diggs Sr., November 7, 1888, September 1968, was a United States acting comptroller of the currency from April 1938 to September 1938. Born in the city of Dallas, Texas on November 7, 1888, Marshall R. Diggs received his J.D. from the School of Law at Yale University in June 1913. He then entered the practice of law in the private sector. During this time, born to Marshall R. Diggs Sr. and his wife as Marshall R. Diggs Jr., January 26, 1926 to June 18, 2015, who would follow his father and obtain his B.A. from Yale University and then his L.L.B. from the School of Law, University of Texas, then followed by admission to the bar in the state of Texas. In January 1934, Marshall R. Diggs Sr. set aside law in the private sector and was in Washington, D.C., having obtained an appointment as executive assistant to the then comptroller of the currency, J.F.T. O'Connor, in the Franklin D. Roosevelt administration. On January 15, 1938, Marshall R. Diggs was sworn into office as the 21st Deputy Comptroller of the Currency, along with Goodwin J. Oppegard, who would serve as the concurrent 22nd Deputy Comptroller of the Currency. However, in April 1938, the then Comptroller of the Currency, J.F.T. O'Connor, resigns from office in order to campaign unsuccessfully for the office of Governor of California, and Diggs quickly finds himself holding the office of Acting Comptroller of the Currency. According to the mentions of his name in the articles of the New York Times from April 1938 to September 1938, Diggs appears to have been quite busy during the short time in which he held the Acting Comptroller office. However, on September 30, 1938, Marshall R. Diggs and Goodwin J. Oppegard both resigned their offices, thereby becoming the shortest ever office holders of the title Deputy Comptroller of the Currency to date since the creation of the office on May 9, 1863. The very next day, Preston Delano was the new Comptroller of the Currency. In October 1938, Marshall R. Diggs Sr. was then moved over to the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, or FDIC, which had been created by legislation on June 16, 1933. While living in D.C., Marshall R. Diggs Sr. got involved in local extracurricular activities. In 1947 to 1948, Diggs served as the president of the Yale Club of Washington. Back in 1905, U.S. President William Howard Taft had held this honorary office. After leaving the public sector, Marshall R. Diggs Sr. returned to the private sector but remained in D.C., even setting up an office at 1025 Connecticut Avenue Northwest with some associates. In May 1959, Diggs Sr. meets Mario Garcia Coley, July 16, 1901 in Cuba to August 1975 in Virginia, who only 3 months earlier had escaped from a Fidel Castro prison in Cuba, and Diggs Sr. agrees to help Coley carry out his plans to remove Fidel Castro from office. While in the private sector, Marshall R. Diggs Sr. will become president of McIntyre Incorporated, whose filing date was September 3, 1958 within the District of Columbia. Then on August 6, 1964, the New York Times carries the following headline: 10 are indicted in sale of stock. Named among the 10 facing a 76-count indictment is the president of McIntyre Inc., Marshall R. Diggs. Within 4 years of this indictment, Marshall R. Diggs would be dead. He died in September 1968 while still living in Washington, D.C. In addition, McIntyre Incorporated's filing status is now listed as revoked. == References